That is all the boards complete. It just leaves us with the Backplane, which is the beast. So suggested configuration is shown using slots 2 to 6, Y-links or resistors needed if slots 1 and 2, 7 or 8 used, 5 volts via barrel jack if jumper fitted, which is the barrel jack. Optional to regulator and caps for 9 in foot. Cover jumper tabs with tape. Deco cap. So, tempted to look at the components afterwards. After we solder all these guys, in. Now, which sense is it going to make? So we've got jumpers as well into these. Do that and that. I think it might just be a case of. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And some extra bits. I have about a gazillion solder joints. Let's just see if the camera's still recording. I'm ashamed to miss all this excitement. Seems to be. Very good. Do you need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. jumpers. What are you up to today? Okay. We don't need these. So these are going to be hello. Okay, quick intermission. Right, so back to the jumpers. These are a bit now. Should I put them all on or just a few? To say just a few is all that's required. Easy. Okay. Push this one through because there's a cock up. As that, only a few. See myself hating jumpers by the end of this, because the other option is to solder links throughout, but I reckon that might be just as time consuming to get very neatly done, which I want it to be all neat and tidy. Up. The bottom ones aren't as long. They're in fact too short. So we're going to have a bottom of two off each one. Okay. That's okay. It's going to switch on first time. Where are we doing? 10 o'clock now, so I'm not going to have too much time to read. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go from right to left, tack on a couple of joints at a time. God, these are wobbly mothers. Make sure the camera's going. Same time. Seems to be. Solder on there. That's good. Slot. Let's keep one on number 8 to keep it balanced. Hello. That is not quite in there. That is extremely frustrating. Tiny bit of solder stuck. Okay, so that bit's down. There's this one down. Be patient here because this is quite nice if it's not so. Okay. Really quite tricky to get on. Okay. Okay, next one in. That is not a method that works. Okay. So what does work? Let's see. Come on, slow down, yeah. That's good. I think it might be taking shape in it. These ones are going to be a bit easier. I wonder if I should have done both ends first. Oh well. I probably should have, it's really quite. Do with just a little bit more push. Just like that. Getting there. This is a shim. Check the camera rolling. Still good. not too bad. Let's give this a bit of a press down. Okay. Now it's time to start soldering. I've never soldered before. Well, I've never soldered since 1998. Well, this is slow going. Running about 10%, I guess. They're not too bad. Into a sort of rhythm. So you get to a pen that doesn't work there. Follow. Surely got to be a dry joint somewhere. Start the camera going again. Small interruption. No way, camera stops. Seems to go for a good while and then just clicks off. Getting to a nice tiny part. That's okay. So, splashes of rosin on the board. Bad joint, up, flow, down,
Well, I'm almost halfway, really. Which is nice. Thank you.
end of my tip is... I think I can turn this round. I like working right-handed at it. Little bits of flux on the board. Okay, back again. Another bit of a battery charge and some copying movies off the SD card. So we're making good progress. Bit more. Pretty hot. Is it hot still? Yeah, good. So it's been a good maybe half an hour since. So I've almost retipped the right. Okay, let's go again. No. Apologies that I'm essentially blocking the entire view. But so it's comfortable. It's a bit more sensible. Maybe having the tripod looking over
from my left would have been better, but never mind.
Solder. Right. Yeah, that was sort of ran through pretty quick, but that was the chance of finding a dry joint. That's with the naked eye, and we're now not too bad. 20 to midnight. Specks of flux, but resin, whatever. Yeah, doesn't seem to be too much else. So what we need to do is, as good a time as any, load up on jumpers. This is going to be dull. So what have we got left? A resistor, the power, might as well solder one on, we've got a spare one. A reset switch, a reset switch, resistor. He's really excited about turning it on. I'm not entirely sure it's going to work. I'm going to be massively excited if it does. Gonna be too surprised if it has some glitches. I'm hoping it's not gonna be too anticlimactic once I do get it working, because I have the IO board and the Pi Zero board. Saw this bag of resistors and thought, my god, what am I going to do with those? Resistors, jumpers, how many have I got? But it turns out that used an absolute shed load of that buggers. And I'm being a bit crazy in making sure that they're all the right way round. Well, that's beginning to look gorgeous. Okay, I guess we go large. Some slightly thicker solder might make this job a bit easier because these are quite gargantuan joints. But what I'm going to do is sellotape this down because I do not want to have to remelt that. Out of the plastic slightly. Bit too eager with it. Oh well. Let's get that last one done. Come on now. Sure, there'll be a technique to that so as not to. Easy. Okay. Reset switch. Now, it only goes in one way around. Well done, it does. So let's just filming. There you are. Slightly, just a touch. in. It's melted ever so slightly. Just enough to get those pins. Just showing. There's not too much, but enough to it's a reset switch, a reset capacitor, which is 2K2. Let's just double check that we have. That's it. A red. Wait, red, is it? Just double check to see what's going on. We have a green brown is a 300 ohm. So that is a 300 ohm. This is a 2K2 and just being done. So the 2K2, so we want to just do some nice pop like that, I think. Let's put that round. That way. Now what we need is some sort of, I wonder if I should put this on first actually. Sure, all the pros use sticky tape. Stick to this normal socket. Let's that. So, power. Decoupling LED cathode marked K is short lead. So, how far down are we going to put that? Jeez, we could put it right on the board, I think. Where do I mark it? Something like it just raised up. It's not a bad distance just to have it. See what I'm doing. And that I'm happy with. So let's get the other one soldered. Now the resistor for said boop and boop again. Getting tired, should have put the resistor in before the lead. It feels quite home. Let's get one leg done. this isn't good. And now I have the choice of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Check we're still filming. Seem to be. Okay, so we are very nearly there. I wonder how solar in that. Definitely need something on the green ones, all the orangey ones. To do 4 of each. Four. That'll be nice and symmetrical. Camera back on, stopped. Miss anything? Okay. Lost all the little shims. Okay. Making hard work of that. Well, almost there.
Suckers.
Let's reflow those, and these should be the last chance. Let's just make sure camera is running out of batteries as well. Fingers crossed. Okay, well, it is officially done. So what we do now is insert all the various bits and brave it out, which in theory would be quite easy to do. There's ground, the clock, super yaw. Take these out again soon, and I suspect it might be so. CPU then ROM placing pin one. Alright. That's a creaking. Pin one, ram. Serial next. Oh, would you look? I forgot an entire bit. After all that. I forgot to do this disaster. Not quite the end. On it. Bridge between two, a bit too eager. The tip of my iron is a makeover. Well, that's not too bad. Okay, now we're actually finished. So I should be able to reach in and find these. You know what, he's not a bad chap, this guy that designed these things, because color matches. That goes there. And
first.
Clearance of that is there. Okay, here goes.